Hello and welcome to BYJU'S IAS, presenting to you the daily quiz for 22nd of May 2021, Saturday. Let us begin and have a look at the first question for today. Bao-dhaan, recently in news, is option A, a medium grain rice grown in Bhutan and Eastern Himalayas. Option B, red parboiled rice variety grown in Palakkad district of Kerala. Option C, a GI tagged variety of rice known for its strong aroma that is widely used in traditional Bengali cuisine. Option D, iron-rich red rice grown in Brahmaputra Valley of Assam. Option D is the right answer. The iron-rich red rice, Bao-dhaan, is grown in Brahmaputra Valley of Assam. This variety of rice is grown without any use of chemical fertilizers. Bao-dhaan is an integral part of Assamese food. It is red in color due to the presence of anthocyanin and therefore is called red rice. Food plants rich in anthocyanin include blueberries, raspberries, black rice and black soybean. Let us discuss the context. This article in PIB has a reference to Bao-dhaan. It reads, recently the first consignment of red rice was sent to the USA from Assam. It also mentions that this variety of rice is iron rich and is grown without the use of any chemical fertilizers. Moving on to the next question. Consider these statements with respect to particularly vulnerable tribal groups. Statement number one, a separate category for primitive tribal groups was created by the Bhuria Commission. India has more than 100 particularly vulnerable tribal groups. Andhra Pradesh has the highest number of PVTGs. What is the context? An article in the Hindu newspaper talks about how COVID-19 is affecting the Dongria Kond, a particularly vulnerable tribal group living in Niyamgiri Hills in Odisha. Coming back to the question, in the year 1973, the Dhibar Commission created primitive tribal groups as a separate category who are less developed among the tribal groups. So this statement is incorrect. And in the year 1975, the Government of India initiated to identify the most vulnerable tribal groups as a separate category and declared 52 such groups. While in the year 1993, an additional 23 groups were added to this category, making it a total of 75. In 2006, the Government of India renamed these primitive tribal groups as particularly vulnerable tribal groups. So the second statement given here is incorrect, as there are only 75 particularly vulnerable tribal groups in India. Among these 75 listed PVTGs, the highest number, that is 13, are found in Odisha, followed by 12 in Andhra Pradesh, making statement number 3 also incorrect. So the right answer to this question is option D, none of the above. Question number 3. Which of the given statements with respect to globally important agricultural heritage system, that is GIAHS, is or are correct? It was conceptualized in 2002 during the World Summit on Sustainable Development in Johannesburg, South Africa. Koraput in Odisha, known for kayal cultivation, is recognized GIAHS site in India. Kuttanad in Kerala and Kashmir Valley's Pampore region are proposed to be recognized as GIAHS sites. Why this question? There is a reference to globally important agricultural heritage systems in today's The Hindu newspaper. The article talks about Koraput region in Eastern Ghats that was accorded the GIAHS status in the year 2012. So let us discuss the answer to the question. Statement number 1 is correct. Statement number 2, Koraput in Odisha, known for kayal cultivation, is wrong. Because while Koraput in Odisha has been accorded the status, kayal cultivation is practiced in Kuttanad in Kerala. The third statement is also incorrect because Kuttanad in Kerala and Pampore in Kashmir have been accorded the status in 2013 and 2011 respectively. So the correct answer to this question would be option B, one only. Global Agricultural Heritage System was started by Food and Agricultural Organization for the purpose of creating public awareness and also safeguarding the world's agricultural heritage sites. It declares an area a repository of agricultural biodiversity, resilient ecosystems, and valuable cultural heritage. As we discussed earlier, Pampore in Kashmir Valley was accorded this status in 2011 for the cultivation of saffron. Koraput in Odisha was given the status in 2012 as the traditional systems in Koraput region are strongly linked to the local traditional communities. Kuttanad in Kerala was accorded this status in 2013 as it is known for kayal cultivation. This is the only place in India where rice is cultivated below the sea level. And this is also known as backwater paddy cultivation. Moving on to question number 4. Which of the following is or are correctly matched? Chipko movement, Uttarakhand. Apiko movement, Andhra Pradesh. Safe Silent Valley movement, Kerala. Jungle Bachao Andolan, Bihar. Given here are major environmental movements and the regions in which they were organized. We will have a look at the context a little later. The Chipko movement was a movement against deforestation and call for maintaining ecological balance. It originated in Chamoli district in the present-day Uttarakhand, so this is correct. The Apiko movement or the Apiko Chaluwali was inspired by Sunderlal Bahuguna's Chipko movement. This took place in Uttar Kannada, that is North Karnataka, and Shimoga districts of Karnataka and North Andhra Pradesh. The Silent Valley movement was an environmental movement against the Silent Valley hydroelectric project that was proposed across the Kuntipuza River that runs through the Silent Valley, an evergreen tropical forest in Kerala. So this is correct. And the Jungle Bachao Andolan was started by the tribals of Singhbhum district of Bihar, making this correct. So the right answer to this question would be option A, 1, 3 and 4 only. Now let us take a look at the previous year question. Which of the following statements is or are correct? Viruses can infect bacteria, fungi, plants. Select the correct answer using the code given below. Option D, 1, 2 and 3 is the right answer. Viruses are known to infect almost any kind of host that has living cells. Bacteria, fungi, plants and animals are all subject to viral infection. We must understand here that all the viruses are obligate parasites. What does an obligate parasite mean? It is a parasitic organism that cannot complete its life cycle without exploiting a suitable host. These viruses lack metabolic machinery of their own to generate energy or to synthesize proteins. So they depend on the host cells of animals, plants, and other microorganisms to carry out these vital functions. The fact of the day for today is Sunderlal Bahuguna. A 94-year-old environmentalist and Chipko movement leader, Sunderlal Bahuguna succumbed to COVID-19. Sunderlal Bahuguna is a noted Gharwali environmentalist and is known for the Chipko movement. He helped the Chipko movement gain prominence and support. This movement was in many ways the beginning of environmental consciousness and such movements in India. For example, the Apiko movement in Karnataka drew inspiration from the Chipko movement. The Chipko movement that started in 1973 was an effort to stop deforestation in the Chamoli district of Uttarakhand. Chipko literally translates to hug. The local women of the Chamoli district then started hugging trees to save trees from being cut. This was an exemplary movement of community protection of forests. Besides taking note of damage done to the ecosystem of Himalayas, Sunderlal Bahuguna was involved in multiple social activities such as the anti-liquor drive. He spread messages of non-violence and adopted Gandhian principles. He was a Gandhian. Sunderlal Bahuguna was also an activist in the anti-Tehri Dam movement during the 1980s, which he led till 2004. The movement against Tehri Dam, a mega project with devastating consequences due to submergence, tree felling, displacement and possible seismic impacts, was unsuccessful even after he undertook one of India's longest fasts after independence. Since Bahuguna was a follower of Gandhi's principles, he used the Satyagraha tactics. The repentance fast or the Prayaschit Satyagraha was undertaken by Bahuguna for 74 days in what he called was a repentance for failed agreement for review of Tehri Dam project in Uttarakhand. However, the work on Tehri Dam on the banks of River Bhagirathi resumed in the year 2001 and the first phase of the dam project was completed in the year 2006. But one thing for sure, the hard and long battle Sunderlal Bahuguna fought for preserving forests in the Himalayas will be etched in the books of history for the years to come. That is all for today. Thank you for watching and keep learning.